Okay, let's continue with a sample space, the set of all possible outcomes of an experiment. Now suppose the experiment is rolling a die. So all of us know that the outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. But we can show the sample space with a set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And now suppose the experiment is the color of playing card for first and second card. We all know that the cards are black or red. The first and second card can be both red or can be both black. Or maybe the first one is red and the second one is black. Or maybe the first one is black and the second one is red. And also we can obtain this sample space by using a tree plot or a tree diagram. But how it works. Okay, now we have two cards. Card 1. And card 2. The outcomes for card 1 are red and black. You just need to write the outcomes for card 2 in front of each outcome of card 1. For example, in front of R, we should write again R. B, it means red, black, and in front of black, we should write again red, black. Now we have the sample space. RR, RB, BR. And B. Okay. And now suppose that the experiment is pulling card until seeing or visiting the first red card. Until observing the first red card. Again, the cards can be red or black. But here, the first red card can be the first card or can be the second card. It means after observing a black card. Or it can be the third card after observing two black cards. And or it can be the fourth card after observing 1, 2, and 3 black cards, and so on. Now look at this example. Three students are randomly selected from the WSD111 class. For each student, it is noted whether he or she passed or failed the first class test. So we are going to write the sample space for all three students in terms of the students passed or failed the first class test. Okay, again we know that the possible outcomes for students A is P or F, or pass or fail. Again, for a student B, the outcomes are P or F, and for a student C, the outcomes are P or F, or pass or fail. So, we can easily plot a tree diagram. And now we have three columns, student A, student B, and student C. For student A, the outcomes are pass or fail. Then in front of pass, we need to write pass, fail again for student B. And in front of F, we need to write pass and fail for student B. And we continue this approach for students 3. Again, for in front of each outcomes here, we need to write pass, fail, pass, fail, pass, fail, and pass, fail. And now we can obtain the sample space P, 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 F, P, F, P, P, F, 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 P, P, F, P, F, 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 P, and F, F, F. Okay, here you can see the sample space as a set of all outcomes of the experiment. Okay, you know about the definition of experiment and the definition of sample space, and now we are going to define event. But what is event? An event is any subset of outcomes contained in the sample space S. You know about the subsets of a set in mathematics. So any subset of the sample space is called event. But if the subset has only one element or one outcome, it's called simple event. But if the subset have more than one element or one outcome, it's called compound event. Okay, you can see the sample space of the previous example here, and these subsets just have one element, so they are called simple events. But here we have two elements and here three elements of this set, so it calls compound events. Oh, they are called compound events. Okay, now we are going to solve exercise 5 from your homework. As you can see, we have a system here consisting of three parts. But before describing the system, we considered S for a functioning components and F for a non-functioning components. So at first we are going to obtain the sample space in terms of each component works or not work. So again, we have component 1, component 2, and component 3. So component 1 can work or not work, fail, success. Again, in front of each one we should write success, fail, success, fail, and again in front of this, success, fail, success, fail, success, fail, and success, fail. Now we can we can write the sample space. So the sample space is S and F. 8 elements. Now okay, now we should know something about the system. Please note that components 2 and 3 are connected in parallel, so the system will work if at least one of them works, and the entire system works if one and 2 work, or 1 and 3 work. So we are going to solve some exercises about this system. Okay, what outcomes are contained in the event A? That exactly 2 out of the 3 components work. Okay, we can go back to sample space. Two of them from 3 works. One of them is this one. Another one is this one. And another one is this one. It means SSF, SFS, and FSS. Now we can see the results here. Again, what outcomes are contained in event B? That at least 2 of the components function. 2 of the components, at least 2 of the components work, it means 2 of them, or more than 2, it means 3 of them. Okay, we just should add SSS to the event A. Okay, he was exactly 2, at least 2. At least 2, it means 2 and more than 2. More than 2, it means 3 of them work. What outcomes are contained in the event C? That the system works. Okay, for working the systems, we can go back here. Okay, if all the elements work, it means the system is working. For other options are the first one should work, or the first one with the second one, or the first one with the third one. So in this case, system is still working. And also in this case, system is still working. So we have 3 elements in event C. Okay, now you all of you know about the experiment, about the sample space, about the event, about the simple and compound events, and about listing sample space and listing events. And again, please do your homework. We already solved exercise 5, but we will help you for the solution of these exercises. And thank you so much.